Hi there, my name is Dan, and this is a free clip from my larger Microsoft Word training course. Check out the link in the description or go to bringyourownlaptop.com for more. Okay, tip number one, I've styled my first heading, but I've got to apply it through this really long document. Click anywhere in the heading, go Control-Shift-C, click anywhere in the headings you want it to go to, Control-Shift-V. Super easy to apply it to lots of different things as you're working through a document. Thank you, Microsoft Word. You're awesome. Tip number two, I've got a PDF. It can't be opened. It's all fixed. Or can it? I can right-click it, go to Open With, Microsoft Word. Microsoft Word's going to say, would you like to convert it into a Word document? You say, no way. Yes way. Okay, and now all of the text is fully editable. And when you're finished, you can hit save and decide to keep it as a Word document or back out as a PDF. Thank you, Word. So tip number three, I've designed a cover page. I've done my contents page and I'm about to style my body copy. I don't have the copy yet, so I want some placeholder text. So instead of going out to lipsum.com, we all love that site. Okay, we're gonna go to equals and we're gonna type in lorem. And in these brackets here, we're gonna type how many paragraphs we want. I want 150, the end here, hit return. Holy moly, easy peasy, mixed up Latin words that I can use as placeholder text until I get my real copy. Great, on to the next tip. Tip number four, I think, is I want this price and I want this price, so I try and drag across them both, but it grabs everything in between. What if there was a way I could do random selections? Watch this, select the first one, hold down Control and Shift, and then click this other one. Look at that, and maybe just this one for fun. Hit copy, new document, and you can see it just brings through the bits I had selected. All right, great tip. Next one, please. Okay, you're working on a document like this newsletter, and the file size is really big because you've got lots of images in it. We want to lower the file size of this Word document. We can do that by clicking any one of the images, go up to Format along the top, and then there's an option that says Compress Pictures. Now untick the one that says apply to just this picture. I'm gonna get it to apply to all the pictures. I'm gonna pick a size. Okay, I'm gonna go down to email size, click OK, hit save, and check your file size. It'll be a lot smaller. To the next tip. Tip number six, I think, probably. This one is to do with measurements, especially when you're dealing with imperial and metric changes all the time like I am. Okay, so I know that this box here needs to be 9 centimeters high, but if I look under format, I can see that it's in inches, and I have no idea what the conversion rate is. But what I can do is select the inches here, type in 9cm, just over the top, okay, and I can click out anywhere, and you see it does the conversion for me. It's now converted it into the exact inches measurement. You can do the exact same thing with pixels or points. And it's not just to do with height and width. Any box in Word that has any sort of measurement, you can just type it in, and it will convert it for you. Thanks, Microsoft. All right, the last tip, and this one is how to change the font size. If I select this heading here, I can hit Control Shift and then full stop to make it bigger, okay, and comma to make it smaller. While we're here, Control B makes it bold, Control I makes it italics. All right, that is the end of our tips and tricks for Microsoft Word. How'd you find that video? Was it good? Was it bad? If you liked it, go check out more of my courses on bringyourownlaptop.com.